Hello, thank you for watching Urban TV People and Profiles. I am your host, Jackie Achan, and on this edition of People and Profiles, we are privileged, if I may say, to have one of Uganda's most loved personalities. If you are perhaps on our social media platforms, you will know this gentleman. He is a retired police officer who retired at the rank of Assistant Inspector General of Police. He served as political commissar for the police force. He also served as the head of Interpol here in Uganda. He's a big football fan. He also, you know, currently is an author. I know he has a book out, and he is a big fan of Arsenal FC. I must say that because every time I've gone on social media, I've found this gentleman being bashed about his love for this UK football team, Arsenal FC. And I would want to start with that, Mr. Asan Kasingye. Yes. I know you have loved Arsenal for quite a long time. I have followed you on social media. I wonder what it felt like to see Arsenal come very close to lifting the trophy this season that has just concluded after a very long time, and letting go of this trophy to Manchester City at the very last moment. The elephant collapsed. What happened?
Thank you so much, Jackie, and thank you for having me here. Yes. On People and Profiles. Mm-hmm. I'm grateful for that, and for the fact that you've come to interview me over this. I thank God.
Right.
Now, over Arsenal. Arsenal has been my club for quite a long time. I should say that my first love is Sports Club Villa. But when I went to UK for a course, my first course outside this country as a police officer, then I was inducted in Arsenal by my colleagues who were on the same course with me. So the love has been from 1995 up to now, you can imagine. And I think the only time I saw us lift the cup, the trophy, was 2003-2004 season. But we have also been lifting the FA Cup, I think. Arsenal could be top holders for the FA Cup. Now, this time from 2004 to 2023, those are almost 20 years, 19 years, we have never seen that cup. It also became worse when we could not even be in the top four, which means no Champions League football for some time. Of course, we started knowing that we are going to lose, you know, we shall, you know, start losing, you know, and then we pick up later. To our surprise, we started winning, and we never lost any game. We are not losing any game until when we faced Manchester City. You remember, we are winning all our games. We saw the possibility of lifting this cup. And I think I was at Urban with the...
is that the sports team?
No, it was not the sports team. It was in the morning.
Oh, yeah. the rush hour show.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And I promised I was going to walk from Entebbe up to Kampala if Arsenal lifted the trophy. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. We made mistakes here and there. We all saw that, there's something missing, and Manchester City had an edge over us. They have been winning for quite some time. They knew what to do, how to win it. I think you saw us getting two players from them, and they added on something. I'm sure this season, we shall lift the cup.
Well, on that note, with that hopeful thought of yours, let's leave it there. We shall come back to the sports later on. But we want today to talk about your service in the force. Still, like I said, most people follow you on social media. They love you. They ask you about football. But they've also come to you several times on matters of policing. I know you have had like over three decades of experience or work.
3 years.
Yeah, in the police force.
Yes.
As somebody who is very outstanding, even after leaving the force, we want to get to know your journey into the police. At what point did it start and where from? Yes.
Let me start by saying that my interface with the police or to see a policeman was way when I was a child, because I come right from where Shema District Headquarters are right now. And at that time, it was a county headquarters called Shema. So I grew up seeing police officers, but these are local administration police officers, okay? So I would see them.
What is the difference between local administration police and normal police?
No, now we have one central police. We have now Uganda police. But at that time, we had Uganda police. At the same time, we had local administration police. This was the local government institution that was that was implementing the local government act, like collection of poll tax, graduated taxes, things to do with markets, you know, order in markets, and that kind of thing, while the police concentrated on the national issues. So I saw them. And I didn't give them much thought because we are used to them. We used to call them names, you know, in Orinyankore, Yurkamfuteri Bare, because we never saw them with guns. The only gun you would see, it was only on special occasions, but normally they didn't have guns. So we named them Yurkamfuteri Bare, meaning if you run away, I will stone you, you know. So that tells you about what we thought about them, about the impression that we had about them. Second time I see police officers is when I went to senior one at St. Kagwa High School, Mushenyi. This was in 1979, after the war against Idi Amin. So we went to secondary school, and in the first term when I was there, there was an altercation between the students and the administration over food. The food was bad, and the administration thought that the students didn't understand the situation that we are in. At the end of the day, there was a strike. We never destroyed anything, but they called in the police. So the police came from Bushenyi police station. When they reached the compound, before they even talked to us, they started shooting in the air. And I'd never seen, you know, bullets of that nature. I saw soldiers during the war. We had, you know, bombs here and there, but somebody shooting near you, it was, I never saw it. And I got scared and we ran away. And I was wondering, why do the police have to shoot? Now you can imagine now my attitude about the police was at its worst, okay? Now, when I came to Makerere University, from 1986 to 1988, we are the guys who were affected by the war. So we only studied 2 years. We studied a 3-year course in 2 years. And we used to see police officers because at Makerere, we had a police post. Now it is a police station. We had a police post. But the attitude of the police towards the, of the university students towards the police was horrible. Because we used to call them, you know, it was belittling them, okay? They never went to school, they are not educated, you know, and that kind of thing. However, when I started my course, because I did political science and economics, we used to have a lot of people coming from government to come to the university and talk to us. And some of us organized ourselves into a study group. And now I don't feel ashamed talking about it. It is even in my book, Chosen. This was NRM study group. And we used to host very many people from government. you know, ministers, people at the NRM secretariat, you know, people who work in civil government agencies. And then they used to tell us the problem of Uganda. Our motivation was to understand what is the problem of Uganda, where we are now, and where do we expect to go. And what came out very well was that government needed students from Makerere University to go into public service, because remember, many people had, some civil servants had run away. Others were being, you know, removed because they were old and, you know, deadwood. You remember that, deadwood. And others, like the police, they needed graduates. So recruitment started in 1987. Okay? There was another group during the times of Obote, 1980, 81, 83, 85. But under the NRM government, 1987, 1988, and that is the time they were coming to us and telling us to join the police. So I got interested, because they said we want graduates, educated people to come to the police and change the police. And that's when I started getting the interest. And lastly, when I was in first year, one of my, I had a roommate who joined police in 1987. That is Senior Commissioner of Police, retired Benjamin Namanya. So he used to come back after training, and I think he was in Tororo or Busia. So he used to come back to Makerere to see us in his police uniform. And he was smart, you know. So that also added my motivation to join the police. Now, lastly, as you go out of the university, that time you had to sit public service interviews. So in no uncertain terms, I indicated that I wanted to join the police, because I had already been convinced. Nobody was going to convince me to join any other. Actually, the three forms they gave us, each form with a different, you know, job, I already indicated on the three forms, police, cadet, assistant, superintendent of police. I had a problem with the organizers, and they thought I didn't know what to do. I told them, I know, I want only police and no other. So I did my interview, I passed, and that's how I joined the police.
Interesting.
Yes.
So at what level did you start in terms of rank and the rise? Was it like?
Graduates starting from cadet, assistant, superintendent of police. That is the rank I started from. But that time, cadet, assistant, superintendents of police were putting on only one star. Because you are a cadet, it's like you like a second lieutenant in the army, because they're also putting one. But this rank in the police is a senior officer's rank, okay? While in the army, a second lieutenant is a junior officer, okay? So in 1991, the nomenclature of the ranks changed. And the cadet assistant superintendent of police will put on three stars over a white background. And once you are confirmed, then you are left with the three stars. That's the rank I started from, much as I used to put on one star when I graduated in 1989 and 1990. I can say I have not, I can say I'm favored.
Are you not?
And that's why.
The same chosen.
And so when I started as the cadet assistant superintendent of police, my first station was Entebbe police station. Had been absorbed in the special branch because of how we were performing in class. But later on, it was decided that we go to uniform. So my year didn't take anyone to special branch, much as I was one of the five people in class that performed so well. Now, when I went to Entebbe police station, I was given an office called MCB, Minor Contraventions Book. They handle matters like assaults, you know, cases that are misdemeanors that would relieve the CID. So you in uniform, you would investigate them, take the suspects to court, and the CID would only remain with serious cases. Now, I was the OC of that office. Assault cases, you know, domestic violence cases. That time they were taken to be misdemeanors, okay? Issues to do with children, pretty much on what the Department for Child and Family Protection does.